Hey guys, we're going to show you, it's not our neighbor's house, but the next street, okay? Karishma's holding the camera, so it's up to her to get the perfect shot. But let me show you a crazy Halloween decoration, and I'll keep talking till we reach there. Thankfully, there are no cars coming, Karishma, so you can get a good shot. Okay, you want to show them? Just zoom in a little, I'll slow down. Okay, you wait for it, wait for it. Woo! Oh man, look at that. There are literally skeletons all over their house.
It's a spooky night fever.
Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And the start of the video is a little saddening because I usually check the dollar to Indian rupee rate, and I just saw it's like 75 of the reasons and what's going on. But every time I check, the rupee versus dollar is changing for the downside, at least for India. And I have a lot of investments and houses in India. So when we live in the US and we pay taxes and we spend in dollars, we always, you know, worry about when we bring all that money and investments from India to the USA. It's going to be less, right? Like when I moved rupees from India to US years ago, it was like $50, 50 rupees for $1. Now it's 75. So everything changes. Like the other side of it, if I send money to India, then it's great. Like if I send my parents any money or my brother any money for whatever reason, if I owe to pay something, or my dad maintains my houses in India, so if I owe for the painting or the renovation or the upkeep of the houses, when I send dollars to India, then it benefits a lot. But, you know, it works both ways. If you're sending money to India, you get more rupees out of it. If you're bringing money from India, which we've been doing a lot because we've worked most of our life in India, and then we moved here for whatever reasons, you know, I know in the comments you can say, why did you move, don't move, and, you know, get into that part of it. That's another tangent. We moved here for our own reasons. But when you move your valuable assets and money and houses that you sell in India to the US, each time the rupee value goes up, in terms of $1 is 75 rupees, it can be $1, 100 rupees in a few months. I don't know, you lose a lot. Oh man, that's kind of scary for NRIs, because and I'm going to surely see a trend of all NRIs moving money from India to the US before things get worse. I know Pakistani dollar is like 180. I mean, dollar to rupee Pakistani is like 180 or 200. I'm not sure. I don't track what goes on in Pakistan that much, but I saw it on some of the news channels. So, you know, you never know, right? Like I have houses in India worth X amount, and if I bring that money here, I will get X minus whatever, because you know that conversion rate. So that's what's a little demotivating, but it's part of life. You know, tomorrow it could have been the other way around, and in 10 years it may be the other way around. And I'm not really talking about me. I'm just making a point because a lot of people who live in India may not think about all this. And I have a lot of subscribers from India, so they may not think this way. But if you're moving to the US, or education in the US, or moving your children to US, and you will have to move money to support them or to pay for those education or fees or buying things or shopping, everything's gonna cost more. Obviously, it's common sense. So that's really scary. So let me know what you guys think about this. I mean, you can benefit a lot too if you're a multimillionaire Indian in the US, earning in the US, and you have family and properties in India. You want to send money to India, and it's very easy to send money to India. Okay, one click of the button, and Mr. Modi will take your dollars. But I keep making these videos because now we are bringing another big tranche of money here from India. Because we want to quickly pay this house up. I told you, I don't like debt and I don't like loans, right? As much as the fun I have in life with bikes and cars and buying everything I want, we don't like loans. So for this house loan, we are bringing a lot of money from India to pay it off. But it's very difficult. Each time you have to fill forms, wait weeks, go up and down, send the forms by courier back to India, pay $100 for the courier fees. It never ends. So we're doing it. We respect all governments and we respect all processes and policies. But it's so funny, right? When you send money from US to India, it's one click. Click, 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 the money goes. But when you bring money from India to the USA, you're like taking weeks of effort. Anyways, I see my daughter and wife have come and I have to drive to the school. So, yes, here is my daughter in her Lakers hoodie. Whoa, LeBron hoodie. That looks cool. I think, is Mama coming too? Priyanka, you're very lucky. You have both parents dropping you to school. Uh-huh. You know? All right. Karishma's here and every video I don't want to trouble Karishma to be part of. Let's see if she says hi. Let's start her up. Subaru time. Hey Karishma.
Hi.
I was just making a video about how the Indian rupee is climbing against the dollar. Not good, no? Anyways, okay guys, off to school, signing off, take care, bye.